It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1580, recorded Thursday, July 21st, 2016. Time on my hands. Thanks to Kaspersky Labs for supporting the Giz Wiz. Get 50% off Kaspersky's Labs premium software, Kaspersky Total Security, by using Giz Wiz at checkout. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, Dick has two gadgets and a way to donate animals. I have a gadget that's a little time consuming, but I hope that you watch. Wink, wink. All that and more next on the Giz Wiz.
It's the same dumb show with Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC. It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
a nerd pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now!
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the maestro of gadgets, Dick DeBartolo. How you doing?
Chad, I'm doing good, sir. And you?
I am doing fantastic. I am doing well. I actually just got back from, oh man, there was a video I wanted to show you. I have it on my phone. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get it to you in time. I actually just got back from the Dell Children's Hospital with this company, Game Changer, delivering games and toys to kids. And we bought food for all of the caregivers there and that sort of stuff.
How great.
But at the Dell Children's Hospital, there is an entire, it's an entire lobby taken up with model trains. And it is humongous.
Oh.
I may have to just point this camera at my phone just so that you can see this. But it is absolutely amazing. Here, let me, I may need to change the settings on this camera on the phone.
That's right. I'm seeing mountains, right?
Yeah, absolutely. So, there we go. You can see it a little bit. Let's bring this back to the beginning. So, yeah, inside of this lobby, this camera does not want to work here. Let me fix this. But yeah, there is a huge, huge area.
Whoa! Oh my. Holy cow.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing.
And are they automated, or do the kids run them, or do they run by themselves?
They all run by themselves. There we go.
Nice.
Let's play this one more time for you. So that's a walkway that people can walk through. It's
two stories tall.
Yeah, it's humongous. You have over on one side, there's here's some people walking up the stairs in this lobby area. Over there, that's sort of a skyline of Dallas. I mean, it is humongous. I was so impressed by the trains that they had in there. And they have one fellow who's been managing, who built it, and has been managing it for 25 years. And it's just really cool. And the kids also, if they've stayed there for a long time, they can put their toys. So there's little figurines throughout, and they'll place it somewhere in the whole thing. So some of the trains go by, and there might be an R2-D2 sitting in it, or Iron Man,
great,
or something. You know, it's really cool. It's really, 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 really cool.
Do they have a Waldo that they can put on a train?
That's what they need.
They
and a cane and a scroll somewhere. Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, that was really impressive. Seeing that, and I thought that you would get a
yeah. Well, you know, it's so funny because I did a thing that was great fun. Every year, I there's a shelter I give to. It's called Little Shelter on Huntington, Long Island, and they have one mega event. The biggest event of the year that they have is in August, and I was recommended to this shelter by a friend of mine, an animal lover, who said they do great work there. And for probably coming up to 10 years now, in June, they call me and go, can you help us? And basically, all year long, when I show stuff mainly on ABC, because on ABC, the stuff tends to be a little higher price stuff, I usually call the manufacturer and say, do you need this sent back or is it okay to give this to a no-kill shelter? And I don't think anybody's ever said no. So they were coming for Dennis and I to fill their van with gadgets. And the day before, I said, you know what? I've never seen the shelter. Can Dennis and I go out in the van and then they'll look around and then we'll take the train home? Because it's an hour and a half outside of the city. So we did that. And I was kind of nervous because I thought, oh, my God, are there going to be poor, sick dogs everywhere? And I'm going to feel. So it turns out that it's really an incredibly well-run place. And what I like about it is, first of all, everybody there is so wonderful. And the woman says, we dogs here, if they're not adopted, they just live forever. And if they get very old and become unadoptable, then we have a farm upstate New York with a caretaker, and they can just go there and live out their entire life.
Wow.
I know. It was really, and they have 6 acres, and they don't let the dogs run crazy through the 6 acres because they're next to, I think she's at a convent. And so they're very aware of barking and noise. And they have 300 volunteers who come in and walk the dogs over the 6 acres and
wow.
play with the dogs. And I was thinking, this is great for someone who would love to have a dog, but their family wouldn't let them. They could just stop by the shelter and say, I want to walk a dog, or, you know, a lot of people bond with a certain dog. It was just a great experience. You can always, if you're hunting around, it's a little shelter. .org, I believe.
It doesn't seem so little if it has so many acres of.
It has 6 acres, and what's wonderful is people will donate something in honor of their pet. Like someone donated a big area with benches for the staff, or not the staff, for guests who want to come in and have their dogs run free near where they are and have lunch there. And it's so carefully thought out and so well worked out. And then they have a walkway where you have dogs, pets and names. Dennis and I are going to chip in and buy stones for Fairway and Maggie. And it's just great.
Amazing. And did you get to see any of your gadgets that were,
it was fun to see them unpack the stuff as it came out of the van. They're going, oh my Star Wars. Is that a cookie jar?
Yeah,
oh,
exactly.
Oh, the Captain America shield. I said, yes, but it's really a backpack for back to school. Oh, so they were freaking out.
That's great.
Yeah, it was just great. It was a fun thing.
That's fantastic. We both got to do our little field trips too.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
Yeah, absolutely. So very, very cool. Well, I guess let's jump into some gadgets.
Yes, okay, we are. So I was doing 2 weeks of gadgets from the New Products Holiday Gift Guide media event. And we're going to start out with two LED gadgets. So let's look at this video. DeBartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv. You know we love LEDs at the Giz Wiz show. This is the brightest LED light I have ever seen. We have it pointing way down, otherwise we're afraid that it would actually kind of blow out the camera. Okay? And we're going to find out, how many lumens is this?
This single light has 13,000 lumens.
13,000 wow. lumens. And you know what? Could you put this light on a dimmer? Some LEDs can't be dimmed. Do you know if you can dim this if you wanted to?
No, it does not have a dimmer. We do sell different filters with it that will throw the light in different directions if you do want it to shine slightly different than what you see here.
Oh, okay.
It does come with an occupancy sensor, so it will turn off and on as you leave the room, but the second it turns on, it will be as bright as it is until it turns back off.
Okay. And this is the smallest model?
Yes, this is the smallest one. We do sell bigger ones as well, but this is ideal for a garage, a workshop, any kind of man cave, things like that. It's great for tinkering. We sell a wall mount as well, so it can pivot 360. So if you have a workbench that you want to be able to have good light on, we also sell a version of this on wheels.
Okay. Now, at the hardware show, there's always a big, big-ass fan booth. And is this a division of that?
Yes. So big-ass fans became big-ass solutions a couple of years ago when we started making this very light. So now we have big-ass fans and big-ass light, and then we also have other products here for the home called
Hype. Do you have any small-ass lights? I see something over here that's a little bit small. Tell me about this, because this is kind of unique.
Yeah, so this is the same big-ass greatness, but just in a much smaller version. This is called our Haiku light. So it is LED as well. It's color-shifting. It's got 16 different brightness settings, so this one is dimmable, if that's what you like. It also has active light equalization, so it will...
And what is that?
So yes, it has brightness sensors in it, so it will be able to tell how bright or dim the room is and then adjust its brightness accordingly.
Oh, great. So you set the brightness you want, and if the sun comes out, it lowers it so that it stays at that brightness.
Exactly. It also does color shifting, so it goes from a really cool white to a really warm amber, depending on if you want to be productive or if you want to be a little bit more relaxed.
Okay, now the big garage light comes with just a plug that you can plug in a wall, and this, I assume, is hardwired?
Yes, this is hardwired into any existing light fixture, whether it be a recess can or a flat junction, you name it, it can fit there.
And prices?
Yeah, the garage light starts at $399, and then again, you have your different mounting options as well, but it also comes standard with the eye hooks that you can mount that way, and then the Haiku light starts at $149.
$149. Are they both out now?
Yes, they are.
Okay, and your website is?
So you can go to haikuhome.com and find both products.
Both products. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Medis writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. Bye.
Do you think, so I was actually looking for a light. I don't know if you remember. I don't know if I said it on the Giz Wiz, but yeah, I was looking for a light to hang up in my garage. It's maybe a little bit outside of my price point.
probably. And also, it's so funny because the chat room is right. I don't know why she's giving HiQ Home as the website. I mean, it does get you there. But they also have big-ass lights.
There you go.
But the HiQ.com has that more sedate ceiling light that has 16 different brightness levels and comes with an app. And also, I like the idea. So you set the brightness you want in the room.
Yeah.
And then it keeps that brightness as the light changes. Comes on when you come in the room. Goes off when you leave the room, which is an option you can turn on and off within the app. But they're very clever.
Very clever. Yeah. Definitely this light fits the name, especially with the stand and everything.
Yes. Well, at the hardware show, I mean, they sell big-ass fans. I mean, when you walk by them, they're as big as you are. So
yeah.
It's not something where they're... You know, I'm sure they were sitting around and someone said, what do we call this thing? And someone said, I don't know, it's a big-ass fan to me. And they just decided, all right.
Okay, all right. Well, we'll do that then.
Yeah, and then after 5 years, they thought, we have to make something else that's big-ass. What are we going to do?
We're into ceiling products, so I guess lights. We'll do lights.
Yeah, lights next. Lights next.
Yeah, and this, this stand is industrial.
It is.
Look at that thing.
Yeah, I think they really tend toward the commercial market with, doing lighting for garages. I mean, that one light is certainly big enough to really light up. In their video on their website, if you go there, they show you that you could put in a bunch of 60-watt bulbs and your garage is still dark, but you put in one of these and it brightly lights up a 10 by 15-foot garage. But it tends to be, commercial use.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I guess I kind of wish that I could... he's throwing a...
Oh, he's throwing... Oh, I didn't see...
Yeah, he's destroying the other competitor's lights.
Oh, my gosh.
And then, I guess
theirs.
Oh,
my word.
He didn't test his, it looked like.
No, that's kind of funny, isn't it?
Yeah, that's so... Interesting. Oh, I guess he got, like, an actual person to test it out. Yeah, they got
I guess they went out and
yeah. Got
now,
it.
Are they testing the lighter?
They're shooting the baseballs at.
Oh, I see. Oh, okay. Oh, all right. Well, you see, you're not going to need that for your garage, right?
No. I think that's a little bit more than I require. When packing orders, though, I mean, it gets crazy. You don't know where an order's going to fly at 90 miles an hour.
Oh, okay. Well, then you might think about it. I'm glad you found that because that's a great video.
Yeah, very great. Interesting. Interesting. So that is the big the ass big garage
the
light.
The big ass light and the haiku more conservative light.
Yeah. Anyway.
Okay. Tea. Are you a tea drinker?
I do like tea. I enjoy black tea, green tea, jasmine, and chai tea.
Favorites. So last week I introduced you to a PR guy I've known for 20 years, yeah. Sam Ash, and he's with Gourmilla, and they talked about the coffee machine that they're coming out with that can do many different formats of coffee all within one machine in a small footprint. But they also are introducing by the holidays, a tea making machine. And Sam Ash returns to tell us about that. Hey, Dickie Bartolo, Mads Medis writer in the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv. You may know the name Gourmilla. A while back, we did their coffee maker, you know, the pod maker that could take like up to a dozen different pod formats and make coffee for you. Well, they have something in the tea vein. And, you know, loose tea is a big thing these days. You know, there's Starbucks has that whole other. Do you know the name of the Starbucks chain?
I'm tempted to say Tevia, but don't quote me.
Tivana. Okay. Where loose tea is in. Well, actually, now we have a loose tea maker, and Sam Ash here is going to show us how this guy works.
Oh, my gosh. That looks so fancy.
Thanks a lot, Dick. Thanks, Dan. Okay. This is our loose tea craft maker. Basically, the reason loose tea is taking off is because once you taste it, you're not going to go back to bags or anything like that. The problem most people have with loose tea is all the, again, technical word, potchke involved. You have to get a little sense bowl. You have to let it steep. And then if you're from Europe, you like your teas steep differently and you like your water temperature differently than if you're from Asia or if you're from South America. There's a lot of ritual attached to tea.
New Jersey has their own set of rules for making tea. Is that not right?
It's called a Passaic River.
Okay.
So what we've done with this machine is that we've really taken the whole ritual and programmed it in for each part of the world, each part of the experience. You program in on the top your temperature and your other settings. You can see over here you want it strong, light, medium. You can program in exactly how you like the tea. And, you know, some people who are used to one part like experimenting a little because that's the beauty of it. We make it easy. And then you have your leaves in here, and it steeps inside the basket. Based on how you like the tea, it'll automatically steep it for that amount of time. And once it's done, it'll automatically pour it into this little carafe or carafe. I never get that right.
Carafe, I say.
Okay, because my mother says glass bowl, so that'll work too.
What is this retail for, and when is it coming along?
This is retailing for $129. It'll be available after the summer for the holiday season.
This is available, as you heard, very shortly. We're recording this at the end of June at the new product show. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Medis writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at GizWiz.tv. I still like coffee better. Bye.
the whole steeping and making sure that the tea leaves are out when it finishes steeping and blah, blah, blah. That's really, there's some people that are really, really, really into that. I remember seeing another sort of device that used a magnet. So you'd take your page and you'd
yes.
set up then it'd drop it and raise it and all sorts of stuff. It didn't look nearly as fancy as that.
Leo bought it.
Yes, yes.
It's from Breville, I think.
Yeah.
And it, yes, you're right. I think there's like a magnetic thing in the handle.
Yes,
and
exactly.
The magnet lowers the thing.
Yes.
And then it, and I think it was like 250 or.
Yeah, it was crazy expensive. Yeah, it was is insane. Yeah. There was no,
anyway, it's a little less expensive.
Yeah.
Just the list price is one basically $130. Also, it's a good looking machine. You know, it looks, I don't know what the wood is, almost looked like it was teak, and that opaque wooden plastic front or acrylic.
Yeah, it's something you'd like to show off. In your
yes,
kitchen.
Exactly. That's the water tank in there, although you know, you don't even physically see the water from the front. I think there's a guide on the side that you can look into. So if you love tea, and you want to spend a little money to have like an ultimate way to make tea, it's the Gourmilla CTC 8000. And I searched all over today and there's not a word about it on the web, but it is going to be out for Christmas, for the holidays,
cool.
I should say.
That is fancy. Anything else? What other gadgets
are there? Okay,
so
this is kind of a redo of a couple of years ago, because I walk into this event this past June and there's a llama. Okay.
An actual llama?
An actual llama. You know, if you go to my website, you could, I should have sent you that picture separately. An 8-month-old llama, and it's a little girl. And the llama, I didn't do a video because every time I walked over to the llama would turn around and walk and stand in the corner.
You go, no, I don't want this.
Does it look like it's wearing, a custom-made blanket, doesn't it?
It does. It looks like it's been freshly sheared.
Sheared, yes.
It has a little hat, though.
It's a great animal. And I talked again a bit with the people from World Vision. And basically, you know, I'll just do the conversation from 2 years ago. They had a goat and a llama. And I said, what are live animals doing at a gift show? And they said, well, you know, for the person who has everything, you don't give them an animal, but we work with 100 third world countries, and people can donate an animal, or at the time, Dennis and I bought a $100 package. We donated a goat and a couple of chickens to a family.
Oh, that's amazing.
I know. Well, my first question was, I said, wouldn't they just eat the goat? and the guy said, no, well, part of the thing they learn quickly is that the goat will give them milk every day. The goat will also produce fertilizer.
Yeah.
The goat will grow up and be able to mate with another goat. And then there'll be
goat
more
cheese eventually.
Goat cheese. Yeah, no. Exactly.
I don't know.
Exactly. So they tend to treat animals that are donated to them very well, because they're actually living off the animals.
Now, are these goats Amazon Prime? I mean, how?
No, they're not them? Amazon. No,
I'm just kidding.
No, they just send them out the door and
they tell the goats the directions.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. It's the World Vision catalog. Oh, and I always worry about where does your money go? And I found this little video. It's a minute and a half or a 2 minute video. Do you have the link to that?
Yeah, I do.
I think this is kind of fascinating. So let's watch it.
Is an act of trust. You want impact. You deserve to know that World Vision has maximized your investment. Did you know that every dollar donated by individuals to World Vision multiplies to about $1.30 in impact? That's crucial leverage to solving the puzzle of poverty for children, families, and their communities. Here's how. When a person gives a dollar to World Vision, on average, most of that dollar, 60 cents, is sent to local community programs around the globe. The rest of the dollar, about 40 cents, is invested in global systems that stretch the power of your dollar through development experts, disaster readiness, donated goods, reliable systems, and fundraising and administration. That 40-cent investment generates around 70 cents of government grants and corporate donated goods, a 175% return. $1 donated multiplies to $1.30 of impact. And there are other multiplying effects that are priceless, like child well-being and fullness of life. It's a smart investment and a safe one because we're accountable to you and to these reputable organizations. And we're accountable to God. As a Christian organization, we are committed to being good stewards of the generous gifts entrusted to us. Learn more about our financial stewardship by visiting worldvision.org.
Wow, interesting.
Yeah, I think if they work with other companies and government agencies to get grants based on the money that they're raising, that it's hopefully the best way that your money's being invested. I have stopped giving to some charities, American Humane Society, I think it is, for dogs. They mail me more crap in the mail, pencils and jewelry and calendars. And I'm thinking, how much money goes to the animals if they're mailing out all? And what it is, it's stuff that is so crappy you won't use it, and it just goes, come on. Yeah, exactly.
There's a great website called Charity Navigator, which does a really good job of ranking charities. So here's World Vision.
Oh, okay.
They get about a 3 out of 4. Here's the American Red Cross, so you can see, not too far off.
Oh, okay. You know what is American Humane Society there? I think it's called.
Is it?
I think it's Humane Society of the U.S. I think it is.
Okay, I'm not going to do a very good job of spelling. We're going to hope.
Oh, okay. I don't think the word American is in it. I think it's just Humane Society. Human, I think, with an E, right? Humane, yeah.
Okay, let me spell check it. Humane. There we go. Society. I don't know what I would do without spell check. We got is it Humane Society of something of America?
Of America, I believe.
Okay, let's look for that.
That's what Charity Navigator.
It doesn't have that.
Okay. But it's good to know about this thing. So that would be like a 75% rating then, right?
Yeah, exactly. So like someone in the chat says, look up Direct Relief International. Here's Direct Relief International. Apparently they're amazing. They're the best charity to ever donate to ever. They have 100.
Give me a 1. Can you can you say 1 and it'll tell you.
Find me something in the 0. So then they also give ratings and why they think that they are good. Information provided and where, fundraising expenses is only 0.2% of...
Is really excellent.
So this is World Vision. You go back over. Fundraising expenses is 10%. So they spend about 10 cents on the dollar. Fundraising efficiency is at 10 cents, not exactly sure. But anyway, so you can see exactly why they've rated it.
This is great.
Yeah. So that's charity. What is it?
Charity Navigator. I'm going to watch this. I'm going to watch this show all the time because I learned so much.
Yeah. So Humane Society International. Someone in the chat room found it here. They are a little bit, to the left of wherever World Vision is, and tells you why and. Stuff like that. So
calendar has crappy pictures. Oh, wow.
Exactly. Right. Someone else found the American Humane Association. Who knows if this is it or not? They're in the 2s, so they're not so great.
That might be them.
And so you can really find out who you're working with.
I think this is great.
Yes.
This is really great.
Yeah, I agree.
Look up Giz Wiz Patreons.
Exactly.
We're nine. 100% of everything.
I think that's a 0.9, Diggy D. Sorry, there's a decimal there.
Okay. No, we spend more than 100% of what we get.
Exactly. You know, there you go. Yeah. Invested in 150% investment inside
the
show.
Yes, your $1 investment results in $3 taken out of my bank account.
Exactly.
Right. To pay for the rest. No, it's great.
Yeah,
Charity Navigator.
Charity Navigator.
All right. And the company's World Vision. And so
what you do is you go there, you buy a donation, and then you give your donation to someone else, saying, hey, look what I did.
And you can chip in and like 10, you can just say, I want to put $20 toward a cow.
Right.
If you don't want to buy a whole cow.
Right. So instead of spending $30 on you, I spend $30 on this World Vision donation.
Yes, then you don't have to worry. Do they have the shirt? Is this the right color? Are they going to like this book?
Yeah.
You know, it's, and I think they'll feel good about it.
Yes. Absolutely. Now, moving on, before we get to my crappy corner, I want to thank our sponsor for this episode, Kaspersky Labs. Kaspersky Labs makes fantastic antivirus protection so that you can be protected against real threat of cybercrime. We have a pretty amazing offer for you. You get 50% off Kaspersky's Lab premium software, Kaspersky Total Security, if you use Giz Wiz at checkout. Kaspersky Labs is an award-winning internet security software that has given 400 million users the power to protect their banking, browsing, shopping, and socializing from dangerous online threats. So I think that this is fantastic. You get 50% off. And Kaspersky has, of course, supported the show with this advertisement. So thank you guys so much, Kaspersky Labs. They have some fantastic features built in to the Total Security software suite. They have some absolute essentials if you're browsing on the internet. One of my favorites, this is just one of the many, many, many features, is a password manager. If you are not using a password manager, you are using the internet wrong. Make sure you have a password manager. And inside of Kaspersky's Total Security, it gives you a password manager. So 50% off. Use GizWiz at checkout. And big thanks to Kaspersky Labs for supporting the Giz Wiz.
Yes.
Now let's move on to
Chad's Crappy Corner.
Is audio going to play?
No, you there don't you go. Need it, but you might want it at Chad's Crappy Corner. Get it.
Okay. So we are in Bluetooth month. Which, of course, means that it has to have Bluetooth installed. So, or embedded in. I'm looking for the box that this came in, but I actually haven't been able to find it since the beginning of the show. Oh, you know what I just did? It was right here. So, this week's gadget is a smartwatch.
Woo!
So, this is a watch that I found on Amazon. That actually, it wasn't too darn expensive. That's kind of, there's been a theme with Chad's Crappy Corner, and it's basically under $20. So, first off, before we even talk about the smartwatch, this thing ranks in at $16.99. So, $17 for this smartwatch. So, a pretty good deal, if I do say so myself. So, what are the features that you get? Well, let me show it off to you. I got mine in red. Comes in many different colors. You can get white or black. And Now, there are. I'm a little upset because you do have to have a companion app for some of the features to work, and that is only on Android. I have an Apple phone, an iOS phone, and some of these features just don't work, which I'm a little bit upset about. But right off the top, you get a screen. I hope it'll focus. It's actually a fairly good screen. It definitely discolors off to the side. You can kind of tell.
You know what, Chad? Last year I did something called I Rule You. Very similar to this, and I realized that the screen wasn't really backlit, but it had a little LED in each corner.
No, this one's actually backlit.
Wow.
Yeah.
Because after 2 weeks, only half my watch lit.
No, this one's fully backlit.
And I paid $5 more than you did.
Oh, my gosh.
You did good.
What? So you have a little Bluetooth menu where you can search for your devices. You have a steps setting. This all feels like Android. So it looks like I'm actually working within Android to do this. It has a sleep mode where you can start and you fall asleep with this watch. It has it's a little cow. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, you got a little cow there sleeping. And it'll tell you how much deep sleep, how much actual sleep.
Then
then you also have a dialer, of course. And then you have a sort of an app. I accidentally tapped that. An app list here. So if we start at the Bluetooth, you have phone book, your messages. I think this will only work with Android. You have a dialer. You have your calls. You have BT Notice, which is asking me to install the app, which I don't have. You have a camera, once again, that's asking you music. It is going to try to connect to my phone, and we'll get that to work. And it will operate, music using the play, pause, next, back, and volume up and down. Let's see if this will actually work. I don't even know if I have music playing. I don't think I have any music playing right now. Then you have your anti-lost, which I think, here, I'll turn it on, alert type, ring. So when it loses its connection, its Bluetooth connection, it'll tell you about it. You have power savings, you have some settings in here. So I'm in the middle. One of the things that has a barometer, which is telling me that my altitude and pressure and temperature and things like that.
Chad, people are looking for a link. So on Amazon, what's the name of it?
So on Amazon, you would look for, let me take over to the PC.
Oh, I got it. Pandaoo. Oh, there it is.
Panadu? I don't know.
Pandu.
Panadu. I don't know. My tallest looks like it.
Pandaroo.
Pandaroo.
Pandaoo.
Pandaoo. I don't know. Now, it does take some downsides. Does take an hour to charge. And I don't.
An hour to charge? That's not much, right?
Really? I thought that was kind of excessive.
Probably going to run like for 24 hours on an hour.
Yeah, just about.
Charge,
just about is what reviews say.
That's good.
It does have a microphone, and I recorded a video. Let me see if I can actually find that video here to play back so that you could hear what it sounds like. And unfortunately, I didn't. You have a no. So I didn't download it and put it into the monocaster yet. So we're gonna have to have to adjust this so that we can actually see it. And there we go. Okay, let's watch this. Here we go.
Hey, Dickie D. I'm here with the Bluetooth smartwatch. This is what it sounds like. This is what it sounds like when I'm not, like, projecting, when I'm just kind of talking like normal. So I would say that the quality isn't all that great, just based off of the first compression. Anytime I tap it or it rubs up against anything, it definitely causes issues. Here's the screen that I see when I'm inside of a call. It looks like I can mute. Mute works. I have a dial. Okay, sending dial tones apparently. So that's what this thing sounds like when I'm on a call.
So I don't think that sounds...
No, it's a little muffled, but again...
It is only $17.
$17.
I wish I had an Android phone because I feel like...
A kid would freak out over this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They would think, oh my gosh, I have my own smartwatch and...
It's, yeah, I guess, I mean, I guess, yeah, yeah, now...
Does it tell time?
It does, and it looked like, oh, well, it's, the time is not correct. Let me see if I can set the time correctly. Clock, time and date. So like here, I'll show you what I'm seeing.
Oh,
here.
Someone in the chat room says, so now you're listening to yourself through the watch and not through your eyeglasses?
Exactly, right? Yeah, now you have to do all that. So I could set the... cancel. Okay, set home city. That was the wrong home city. Do you think it's gonna have Dallas? I doubt it.
It might. Dallas. Guam?
Where am I? Where are we going? Jakarta? I'm confused. That was the wrong city.
Someone said the watch only comes with hours and minutes, but Chicago, the seconds are sold separately.
Okay, let's see if that worked. No, it's still the wrong time. Okay. But, so it's a little bit, obviously, a little bit hard to kind of click.
But even no matter what city you were in, wouldn't the minutes supposed to be right?
I was wondering if it was auto-set to...
okay.
You know, it would reset. What day is it? It's the 21st. Oh, my gosh. There we go. Set time. It is currently 7.
Oh, okay, bleak.
16. So it's not too difficult to set. There we go. Time format. Update time with the what? Update time with the time zone. Okay. Yes. Turn that on. Done. So there we go. Now it's the correct time.
Wow!
Oh, it's like that. It says A.M. Up there at the top. This is not A.M. I didn't set that.
Yeah, but that's okay.
Yeah, I can reset that.
Could just change that with a magic marker.
Exactly.
Just
I mean,
draw
for the
right
cost.
On it. Yeah, for the
definitely,
cost.
Definitely. So, inbox. Yeah. So without an Android phone. There's certain things, like especially messages, you know, if I try to go to my inbox, it says that I must have the app. So for an iPhone, I would definitely not suggest it. But if you have an Android phone, I
tell you, $17 is just knockout amazing, I think.
And, you know, it was one thing that, you know, popped into mind was, if we had this watch back when all the smartwatches were coming out, I think that it would be pretty good. But we didn't, and now we have a lot better smartwatches out there. So, so the apps that come on it, which are required basically for Android, are the music, the stopwatch, the camera, the BT Notice.
And when you say like music, that. You're talking about controlling the music.
Yeah, like choosing right. which music to play and things like that. So yeah, that's the Panda U8 smartwatch for Android smartphones. Oh, I guess it said that in the title. Did not say that in the title before? I didn't see that in the title before. If that
okay,
was.
Well, it comes in red and black and
red,
white.
Red, black, and white, yep.
Wow.
Yep, and then, of course, it is Bluetooth ready, so we got that requirement fixed. Now, there the reviews, there's 25 one-star reviews, To point that out there. Let me see if I can. Oh, a waste. Still can't get it to work. A waste of money. Very disappointed. Had many problems and didn't work correctly. So. But
I mean, I think the thing is when you consider the price, and like I said, if you have to give a, if the kid is saying, "I want an Apple Watch," just say, "This is an Apple Watch." Yeah.
And then you were saying the I Rule You, which is this. There's a whole bunch of these.
Right.
You know, this is way back.
Mine was not made as well as yours. Mine was lit with two LEDs, one in each corner, and. A couple of days in, one of them burned out, and so the watch sort of was bright in one corner and then tapered off into nothingness.
I kind of remember this one. It had I think I called this the Taco Bell logo.
Yes, yes. Exactly.
In the middle there.
Exactly.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Right.
Okay, well, there you go. There you have it. The smartwatch, Bluetooth smartwatch, $617 if you want to come in stylish colors. That is it for Chad's Crappy Corner. Now moving on to Get Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play. In Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn.
And this gadget warehouse is an old-fashioned 1950-era gadget. So let's watch Ivan's video.
Hey, guys, it's Ivan Hahn here. And the other day I was looking at my podcasting lights and I realized that I have something that you might be interested in. It's an old 1950s Powell lights. It came with the purchase of a Bell and Howell 8mm movie camera, silent film movie camera. And this thing folds in half.
And whoa!
It is portable. Right now I have two higher tech light bulb, LED light bulbs in it, but it can hold any wattage of light bulb that you want, and it's something that I still use today. All you need is a extension cord, and you pop it in right in the back.
Interesting.
And you have one setting for on, and one setting for lower on.
Lower on.
So lower on, that's funny.
That I found.
I think we have your garage light, Chad.
I needed.
Powell Products Fold Aluma Watt Light.
That is actually really cool.
I had one of those.
You did?
I had the big version that took four spotlights.
Wow.
I know.
What is that thing called? The Paolo what?
Powell light, like Powellite, I think. They're made out of metal. They weighed a ton. I mean, it's a riot that back then that was the portable light.
Right. The so easy to carry.
It folded in half and you only needed a small suitcase for that. Anyway, that is from Ivan Hahn, Brick, New Jersey, Hahn, H-A-H-N. And Ivan, you're going to get a Mad Magazine and an Alfred E. Newman picture because we used your video. And we're looking for more. I do have a couple in the house, but we always need more videos. So make a video. Ivan's video is perfect, like 2 minutes, something you have. Even if you don't use it anymore, we know it's in the garage. And it's in the garage because you can't throw it out. A dozen times. I don't know if you ever – have you ever thrown something out? And then walk by the trash bin and
yes,
said,
and pulled it out and go,
yes,
you know what? Just in case.
I know. Sometimes I say to Dennis, I cannot be spending $400 a month for the warehouse. Let's go today and let's fill a bucket with crap. And we do. And on the way to the dumpster, I usually pick out four things. I go, you know, no, we can't throw that. At least I throw something out. But it's very hard to put those kind of things. Anything old, people love to see and hear about, or a great gadget, or if you bought a piece of crap. If you found a $17 something on Amazon and you used it and it was awful, make a video about that. Okay.
Look at this. Look, we found the
there
light.
You go.
We found it.
Is it on eBay?
Yeah, this one's on eBay for $15. This one, my tallest found this. And then, who was it? Eric Duckman found the four light version.
There you go.
Wow. And then he even found this photo of a case that fit the four light version. This seems like an interesting thing. You know, I could see this at a convention or something where you just pop this out real fast and folds up. My tallest also found the four light version, it looks like, on eBay for $53. Oh my gosh. I can't tell if I would really want this or not.
No, because they weigh a lot. You know what? Even if you bought that thing I did a few weeks ago, Lumi Tower.
Yes, yeah.
The Lumi Tower is 60 LEDs in a little tower that weighs 8 ounces.
Yeah, this is pretty heavy. You got to hand it to the palette.
But logos were great.
Logos, they never made logos like this.
They meant something, and it's a Lumawade.
A Lumawade. Powell Products Incorporated, Chicago, ILL, dot, dot.
Oh, that's a riot.
Yeah, a riot. Wow. It comes with the original bulbs, even.
It does, and box. And I love the fact, is it bright dim? Is that the other thing?
Yeah, it was bright
because I've never
dim.
Seen bright. You don't normally see dim.
Bright, it's too bright. High, it's low, too bright.
Too bright and just about right.
Oh, man. That is interesting. Great. It feels like everything's been made before.
Yes. Yes.
Interesting.
What are those?
I think these are the original bulb covers.
Yes, they're the next that came with the bulbs that I think it tells you various things about how much light they are at how many feet.
Yeah. I mean, these bulbs look very interesting. They're
actual photo bulbs.
Yeah. Interesting. Huh.
It's great. It's great. So make a video, put on YouTube, check unlisted, and then only people with the URL or the link can see it, and send the link on to us. It goes to mail@gizwiz.tv, and if we show it, we will send you the current issue of Mad Magazine and one of those Alfred E. Newman 28-year-old pictures. So, Ivan, thank you. Do it. And you know what? Also, send us some letters. We're running out of letters. You know, if you have complaints against the show, send them to Chad. If it's something wonderful, send them to me. No matter what it is, goes to mail@gizwiz.tv. You know, things you want to see us do, or things that make you happy, or things that make you sad.
But don't make comments about products. You know, if you had a PAL light and it caught on fire and destroyed your house, you know, tell us about it.
We want to know that.
Yeah.
We want to pass on your misery to save other people from getting stuck in and being miserable.
Exactly. So moving on to the letter.
Here come the Giz Wiz letters now.
And our letter says, there's another website and store you guys should know about. It's Harbor Freight.
I love Harbor Freight.
This store sells awesome tools. I go there with my son just to look. There's one location in New York in the borough of Brooklyn. Note, I was born there. Not in the store, but in Brooklyn. The good thing is the store is near the Brooklyn Micro Center. So if you have 5 or 6 hours to spare, you could visit both stores. That's how long it took me to finish browsing both stores. Love the show. Keep up the good work, Mo. Yes, I've bought stuff from Harbor Freight. Some of it is...
crummy.
Oh, you know what? click on that greenhouse.
This greenhouse, okay.
Yes, because I have a greenhouse in my backyard. So at the front of the thing, it says 319, and then it says 219 with coupon. So just click add to cart, okay? And then it says
– okay. So
put in that coupon code.
Oh, God, it says, I gotta go back. Okay.
It goes 9. So it says just use 8.
Copy. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Paste. Okay. Apply.
Okay.
Coupon.
Oh, yours worked. Mine said coupon code invalid.
Well, it says it at the top, coupon code not valid, only one per, but then it gives me the discount.
Oh.
I'm confused.
So was I. I typed it in and it said use valid coupon. I'm saying, how? What do you want? You outlined it in yellow. Anyway.
That's
weird. It is weird. They need help maybe with their website. Also,
yeah.
What is a micro center? Have you heard of that?
I think that's like a micro mall. I don't know. What is a micro center?
Micro center is a computer. Just type in, I guess, micro center Brooklyn. And maybe we discovered something else new. But Harbor Freight has, you know, heavy-duty stuff, generators. And Micro Center is a...
computer and electronics store.
Oh, okay. Oh, my goodness. Yes, I could spend a lot of time in one of those.
Yeah.
I guess it's like a Best Buy just for computers.
Yeah. So, yeah, Best Buy sells a lot that's not computers nowadays.
Yes.
Yeah, I actually was just at Harbor Freight over the weekend. I ended up building out a set in my streaming area, a whole wall. I added bricks and pillars and stuff. And
we
really needed a, oh gosh, what is that thing called? It's a...
a wall?
No, we needed a saw. But it's the one that lays, you know, that has a flat platform, and then you pull it down to cut it. It has a specific name, and
okay.
miter saw. I needed a miter saw.
Wow, that's an expensive thing, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It definitely is. And I was trying to rent one, but the rental was going. It was going to be like $45 for the rental. And I drove all the way, I had to drive, pretty far to get to a Home Depot, and I still don't have a valid driver's license because my California one expired the day after I moved. It's been a process to get the Texas one. So I still don't have a valid driver's license, so they wouldn't rent me, the miter saw. So the next best thing, I went on Craigslist, tried to find another one. There wasn't any in my area, and so I went to Harbor Freight. Harbor Freight was just down the road. All their products are, they have a lot of good features. It was going to be $120 for a 10-inch miter saw at Home Depot, and it was, they do this in amps. It was a... I believe it was a 13-amp miter saw at Home Depot. The one at Harbor Freight was 15 amps and the same price, except as I checked out, she says, do you have our coupon? It's like, well, what is this coupon? She said,
they must be crazy about coupons.
Yeah, they're
Harbor
super
Freight.
Crazy about coupons. She says, if you text this number, you'll get 20% off your most expensive item. And it's like, okay, yes, please. So I got $20 off, and it ended up being, under $100 now.
Oh, great.
And then my father works at a shop. He teaches a shop class, wood shop, at middle school. So I said, does your middle school need a miter saw? And he said, yes. So what I'll end up doing is I'll take the $45 off what would have cost me to rent it. And I'll, you know, so he's getting the saw for like $55, basically.
Oh, okay.
So I'm going to give it to the middle school, once I'm completely finished with the project. But I also got a shop vac. I got a shop vac for $15.
And no coupon for that?
No coupon for that one, unfortunately. But yeah, they have everything, and it's much more of of a of like a tool shop, yes. You know, a store. And so they'll have things like lifts. They'll have hydraulic presses. They'll even have
greenhouses.
They
have 8 by 10 foot greenhouses.
Yes, they'll have they have like containers where you could sandblast things. You could buy engines just in like a 2-stroke engine. Just it's sitting there, and you could put it in your project. So they have that or winches. Like if you need a winch for your car. They have all sorts of stuff there. It's actually a really cool shop. And the thing is, things are so inexpensive. Like, let's say the clamps. So I was looking at Home Depot at wood clamps to, like, do wood glue projects and stuff like that. $15 for a clamp. At Harbor Freight, $5. Even if it's the crummiest clamp in the world, which it really isn't, you could buy 3 of them, you know, in the lifetime of the other clamp easily.
Yeah.
So Harbor Freight is a great store, a really good store. Great letter. Good letter.
Yes, Mo. Thank you, sir.
And with that, we want to give a big thank you to our patrons over at patreon.com. You guys make the show happen every single week.
Absolutely.
Big, big thank you to our patrons. Patreon.com, which is where you can support the show. It's a platform for content creators and viewers like yourself to support independent content creators. And our page is patreon.com/GizWiz. And we share posts. We're coming up on the, I only have one more gadget in Bluetooth month. So we're going to have to figure out what the next gadget is going to be. And we ask our patrons over at patreon.com/GizWiz. If you like the show, please support $1 a show. That's fantastic. If you want to give more, please do. We really appreciate your generosity. So thank you so, 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 so much. If you want to watch the show live, we're live every Thursday at around, 4:30 Pacific, 7:30
Eastern. 7:30 Eastern.
And we are at live, I almost said the wrong URL. We're at gizwiz.tv. That is where you can see the show. We have a chat room there. Join. If you don't catch it live, don't worry. Or, by the way, if you show up a little bit ahead of time before we're actually live at 7:30 p.m. Pacific, you'll see a countdown here. Don't worry. The show will start automatically by the time that we actually start the show, if you see that countdown. So don't worry about it. Or if it's just black.
Sometimes we're like just rehearsing. We're trying to get everything just black. Perfect.
Sometimes we have script changes. You know, I have a makeup artist come in.
Yeah.
Make sure that I look good. Yeah. So it's a little bit of prep before the show.
You're right. Sometimes it's up to 7 minutes that we talk before we go on the air.
Exactly.
Right.
It's quality 7 minutes. If you didn't catch the show live, don't worry. We got it for you. Just head on over to gizwiz.tv and hit the episode
set. Oh, we record these.
This one, yeah. Yeah. It's an expensive process of tape and film. Yeah.
That was a clever idea.
Yeah.
That was a clever idea.
Very, yeah. I think technology's going somewhere.
Yeah.
If I do say so. Do say so myself. Also, make sure you head on over to gizwiz.biz. We got two URLs, .tv and .biz. Over there at gizwiz.biz, that's what Dick runs, and he writes up fantastic articles about all of the gadgets that we write. If you need links to those articles, sometimes you have to click multiple pages on gizwiz.tv. We link back to the articles so that you can easily find them. Also, play What the Heck Is It? Have people guessed? Do people know what this is?
A couple people do.
But not as much as last month's or 2 months
ago. No, last month I was like, oh my gosh. People go, what are you kidding? I use those every day. So does my neighbor.
That's perfect. Okay, so this is the game where it's a gadget. It's a full gadget. There's a whole photo of everything. And you have to figure out what the heck it is. I would say this is a device for, it, you know, you have spoons and forks. Well, you gotta have a device specifically for pizza slices. So it is a pizza slice utensil for eating pizza. That's definitely what it is. Sorry for giving it away. You know, everyone's going to now know. But if you think you have a different answer, there are 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers, but 24, double the Mad Magazines, with Dick's signature on them for funny, hilarious, adorable, exciting answers, creative answers to what this gadget could be used for. So get a guessin' over at gizwiz.biz. Anything else for the show? I think that's about it.
No, I think that is it.
We will see you next week.
And I'll be here.